Hello guys, Life Hackster here. Today, I'll show you guys a little project that I did. We lived in this house going on 13 years this coming July. And as I mentioned in my past videos, is that corrosion and oxidation is pretty harsh around here to anything that stays outside the house. You just need to see what my galvanized shed looks like. I know I need to have it replaced. I think this year, but anyhow, oxidation is bad. And look at my front porch light. These are aluminum, but their coating have flaked off. I think I used the lights just for a couple of years when we moved in, and after that, I changed the bulbs to CFL. By the way, those are CFL candelabra bulbs, which are hard to find at that time, and eventually they just stopped working. I really didn't think about fixing or replacing it. This light is on the same switch circuit with my ceiling light, which I always have it on at night. I had a timer switch then, which I now replace with a smart switch by TP-Link, which I have reviewed before, and I will link the review video in the description down below. Toucan recently reached out to me and see if I can review and check out their DIY security camera kit, which is an add-on camera and a smart socket to your existing outdoor lights, specifically wall lights that have the A15 or the A19 sized bulbs, you know, those medium-based bulbs. Take note though that there are a lot of outdoor wall lights just like the one I'm replacing that uses the three candelabra bulbs, which this camera kit will not work. Kuna, which is the main company that sells the Toucan and also the Maximus lights, is the software company behind these cameras. They also sell porch lights that have a security camera built in, which will be an easy install and setup. But Toucan is a separate company and only makes this camera kit. Everything else is made by Maximus, which is a different company from Toucan. I know, it is a bit confusing. Initially, I was planning to just wire brush clean and repaint my wall light, but the bolts and the mount are rusted, and the builders never caulked the base and wall junction. And I'm pretty sure rainwater got in and insects decided to make the junction box their home. So guys, if you have wall lights like the one I have, can you check if whoever installed it placed some type of gasket or caulk at the base to make it at least weatherproof? Comment down below if yours are the same as mine, exposed to the elements. So I decided to just get a new porch light and I agreed with Toucan to send me their camera for me to check out. Thank you, Toucan. By the way, I also have the Maximus floodlight, which is also from Kuna, and I will link my review video down below. First, I will install my new front porch light, which overall is a pretty install. Just remove the old and rusted screws and brackets from my old light, install the new brackets in and connect the ground. Then the black and white wires, and just slide your new light in and bolt it in place. Now, the new light doesn't come with any gasket for the base, so I needed to caulk this in place. Overall, my front porch has a refreshed look. So, time to check out the features of the Toucan surveillance kit. So, this will come with a camera and also a smart socket that will have a USB port that will power up the camera. This is weatherproof, which was tested in negative 40 degrees to 131 degrees Fahrenheit. Also, I learned something. Look at negative 40 degrees in Fahrenheit and Celsius. They are the same. I had to double check and it is. Mind blown. You learn something every day. You can use LED, CFL, or incandescent bulb up to 40 watts and needs to be the regular medium-based bulbs. The lights are motion activated and also can set it dusk till dawn and can use Amazon Alexa and Google to control the lights. This is only a 720p resolution camera. Come on guys, it is already 2019. I know that this camera has been out for a while, but Toucan need to update these at least 1080p or better yet 4K. Anyways, it has a 116 degree field of view and with a manually adjustable lens up to 40 degrees left, right, up or down. It is optimized to detect objects up to 10 feet. That is pretty short distance for a security camera. It uses a PIR sensor, but if you sign up with their AI subscription service, then the PIR is replaced with algorithm camera-based detection. It has no night vision, just like the Maximus floodlight, and will rely on the light to get the full color recording. It has two-way audio and a siren. So, let's open up the box. Packaging and presentation of this camera is pretty nice. So, we have the camera unit itself, We have some 3M mounting tape at the back, or you can also screw it in. At the top is the speaker. We have the camera lens, which you can move and reposition by pushing the sides of the lens down and move it 40 degrees left, right, or up and down. Then we have the PIR sensor at the bottom. And we have a lock screw here on the side. Then we have the smart socket, which has a 40 watt max sticker. So to get the most light output on this, you need to install an LED bulb. On the side, there is a little cover that you need to pop off to show the USB port that will be used to power up the camera. Then we have the micro USB cable, mounting screws, washers, and plastic anchors. We have the Allen wrench, wire clips, and the lens visor. Then we have an aluminum and adjustable cable cover. We have a quick start guide, some window stickers, and a reminder sticker to keep the light switched to on. Let's now install this camera before setting it up. We just need to screw in the smart socket to the light. Make sure you have access to the USB port. Plug in the micro USB cable and just try to be creative on where you're going to route the wires. I have to loosen up the top of the lamp so that I can route the USB cable on top and at the back. I remove the camera from the base and mount the base using the 3M mounting tape directly to the brick wall. I also installed the aluminum cable cover for a cleaner look. Plugged in the micro USB cable to the camera and coil in the extra cable and twist the camera back in place. I also locked the camera using the included Allen wrench. Lastly, I installed the lens hood so as to prevent light glare on the camera when recording and viewing at night. So the finished install will look like this. The smart socket installed and the USB cable routed up and back. It goes down to the camera, which I secure the cable using the stick-on cable clips. It goes in the cable cover and to the camera. Time to install and set up the camera on my phone. First, you need to download or open up the Kuna app. Click the plus sign on the upper right corner. Select Toucan and click Setup Device. Make sure the switch is on and the camera has power. The app will automatically search and look for new devices. Name the camera, which I'll name Front Yard. Select the Wi-Fi network and type in the password. Wait until the camera connects successfully. Follow the setup prompts to finish the setup. Now, time to set up the smart socket, which you need to get closer to the camera. Tap to search for smart sockets. Check to see if the light is flashing. Click yes, and click OK. And now the smart socket is configured. Now, we will just test the camera and light controls. Lights turn on, lights turns off. Let's check out the settings of the Toucan in the app. On the main view, you can see all the Kuna cameras you have in your account. In here, you can turn on or off the light. Click on the gear icon to go to the settings. You can view the serial number, change Wi-Fi network, device health, and share your camera options and time settings. Then we have the status light, on or off. Receive push notifications, on or off. Then light settings. In here, you can schedule the light. But for me, I'll just use the dusk till dawn feature. You'll have a lot of other settings here, like turning on the light when there is motion. Now remember, this camera has no night vision. So if the light is off at night, then it will be totally dark. If you set it to just turn on when there is motion, you will not be able to see whoever triggered the motion until the light is on. One neat feature of this camera is that we'll start recording 10 seconds before motion has been detected. So, if you set the light to just turn on when there's motion at night, then it will just be dark in the first 10 seconds. So, the best setting for the light to use with the camera is to use the dusk till dawn feature, and you will get the whole recording in full color up to where the light shines. Then we have the AI Smart Detection. This is a subscription-based feature which I didn't like then, when I was testing the Maximus floodlight about a year ago. Which I will also leave the link to the review in the description down below. It was missing important alerts, but for now, with the Toucan, it is spot on. So Kuna has been updating this feature and hopefully it will just get better. You can set it to detect people or cars or both, and you can set zones on each. You can also change the sensitivity of the detection. If you don't subscribe to the Kuna AI, then you will get the sensitivity slider for the PIR sensor, which there are no zoning. This works okay with my Maximus, but for now, while I'm on the Kuna AI trial, I'll use this feature for the Toucan. So let's talk about the Kuna Premium. You don't have to subscribe to it, and you will get the most of the features of the camera, except for the recorded footage, which will only have a 2-hour look back. And you can download the footage for up to 3 downloads a month. As to the Premium, it starts with $5 a month for one camera and has a 7-day look back, unlimited downloads, theft protection, and access to the Kuna AI detection. There is a $10 a month option for up to 4 cameras and a 14-day recorded video access, and $20 a month for up to 8 Kuna cameras and 30-day look back. Then we have the greetings, which you can play a sound when motion is detected. You can choose from the following.
Hi, we can't answer the door right now, but the camera is recording. So please just leave us a message. Thanks for coming by. I'm sorry, we're pretty busy right now. Hi, can I help you? I'm sorry, we're not interested.
I'll go with the regular chime. Now, on live view, you can flip your phone to change it to landscape full view. You can start two-way audio by clicking the mic and hold to talk, release to listen. Pushing the three dots option will get you to play a message, record the live view, and sound the siren or call 911. Then we have the light control. Time to do some testing.
This is the audio and video quality of the Toucan camera. Twenty-five feet, 15, 10. So this is the video quality of the Toucan security camera at night. So this is how it looks like when the lights are automatic and only can turn on when its motion is detected.
Alright, it is 10:54 and we're gonna test the motion alert notification speed of the Toucan camera, and let's see how it goes. I have my LTE connection. Notified. So it's 10:55. We are gonna check the cool off notification of the Toucan camera. Yep, got notified within a minute.
This is the audio quality coming out from the Toucan camera.
Another feature that I like, aside from almost instant alert motion notification, is that if you press and hold the alert, and it will give you a GIF preview. So, what do you think, guys? Everything works good with this camera, and my main complaint is the resolution. They need to update this with at least a 1080p sensor. Video quality is decent for a 720p camera though. on where I install this, which is before it gets to my front door. This area is what I call a no man's zone. Meaning if you are in this area, you can't be a passerby from the sidewalk. You have the intention to get to my front door. So any alerts from this camera is an alert that needs to be checked. I also like the chime whenever it senses motion. It will get the visitor's attention that they are being recorded. Any questions? Comment down below. That's it guys, and thanks for watching. And I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. And click that little bell icon so that you'll get notified whenever I upload new review videos like this video, comparison videos, product updates, and long-term reviews. Thank you.